Let's look at how FAGUS adapts the reinforcement, if we so desire, to the stirrups that we inserted in previous chapters. Here's an example. Let's define a stirrup diameter of 6 millimeters to have a mandrel, which will be 4 times the diameter, or 24 millimeters, which will fit well with our reinforcement of 25, so as to clearly understand what's occurring. So let's click on Apply, and now Redraw, and we can now go to the Reinforcement tab sheet and insert an especially large concrete cover just to make it easier to observe. And we can go ahead and create a line reinforcement of 25 millimeters that will be extremely separated from the outline, but that will help us to see the two types of adaptations that the program carries out. So let's create our line reinforcement with two bars of 25, and we'll draw it from here to here using the auxiliary line that we inserted for support, and now we've got our reinforcement. Let's observe how this icon here tells us how the program is going to adapt the reinforcement to our stirrup. In this case, although we're jumping ahead a bit, we should keep in mind that when we go to reinforcement design and introduce our different load cases, we have multiple methods for executing analysis. First, we have an analysis with a graph, if we've selected a line, or an interactive selection of reinforcement, or with numeric outputs of results. If you recall, we saw that the program makes an adjustment for the reinforcement based on certain parameters. So to better understand those parameters, let's go ahead and modify them so as to tell the program how we want the adjustment to be. If we double-click on the reinforcement that we just inserted, we'll see in the lower region here, we can define how we want the program to execute the adaptation. We can establish that we don't want our reinforcement adapted to the nearest stirrup, that it should be adapted to the nearest stirrup, or that it should be adapted to the corners of the nearest stirrup. Here we can see the differences between adapting it to the stirrup or adapting it to the corner of the stirrup. If we opt to move the reinforcement toward the stirrup and click on this button to adapt the geometry of the reinforcement, it will clearly move toward the stirrup, although not to the corner. So let's click on it, and in fact we see exactly what occurs. If we move back one step with Ctrl-Z, and again edit our reinforcement with a double click, we can establish that we want the adjustment to be toward the corner of the stirrup. Apply, and close the window, zoom out a bit, and now we'll see what the program would do automatically if we clicked on the gray lightning bolt in the analysis area. So click on Adapt Reinforcement, and the program has now placed the reinforcement at the corner of the stirrup. In this case, it is aesthetically ideal since the mandrel is of 24 and the reinforcement is of 25. Regardless, the program will execute this adaptation correctly.